Dear students, warm welcome to you to this class of Arabic. So far you have already learned some basic Arabic. In this lesson, we will learn the use of incomplete verbs in Arabic. Don't be panicked too much about the complexities of grammar. We will try to make it as simple as possible. Please read the following sentences with me. كَانَ الْوَلَدُ قَائِمًا كَانَ الْوَلَدُ قَائِمًا The boy was standing. كَانَتِ الْبِنْتُ قَائِمَةً كَانَتِ الْبِنْتُ قَائِمَةً The girl was standing. كَانَ الْبَيْتُ جَدِيدًا كَانَ الْبَيْتُ جَدِيدًا The house was new. كَانَتِ الْمَدْرَسَةُ جَدِيدَةً كَانَتِ الْمَدْرَسَةُ جَدِيدَةً The school was new. كان المطار كبيرا. كان المطار كبيرا. The airport was big. كانت الحافلة كبيرة. كانت الحافلة كبيرة. The bus oblique vehicle was big. كان الفندق جميلا. كان الفندق جميلا. The hotel was beautiful. كانت الحقيبة جميلة. كانت الحقيبة جميلة. The bag was beautiful. كان المكتب بعيدا. كان المكتب بعيدا. The office was far. كانت المكتبة بعيدة. كانت المكتبة بعيدة. The library was far. Dear students, you have noticed that every sentence in the above lesson has started with kana or kanat. Kana for male, singular, and kanat for female, singular. Both the words gave the meaning of was in English language. As I said, kana is used for singular male and kanat is used for singular female. Kana or kanat is one of the many incomplete verbs in Arabic. Now, let us learn the common incomplete verbs in Arabic. صار الولد مهذبا. صار الولد مهذبا. The boy became polite. صارت البنت مهذبة. صارت البنت مهذبة. The girl became polite. صار الجو لطيفا. صار الجو لطيفا. The weather or atmosphere became pleasant. Saratil Hindu Mashhuratan. Saratil Hindu Mashhuratan. India became famous. Sarar Rajulu Ghaniyan. Sarar Rajulu Ghaniyan. The man became rich. Saratil Mar'atu Ghaniyatan. Saratil Mar'atu Ghaniyatan. The woman became rich. Sarat Tilmidu Masruran. Sarat Tilmidu Masruran. The pupil, male, became happy. Saratit Tilmidatu Masruratan. Saratit Tilmidatu Masruratan. The female pupil became happy. Sarat Tiflu Hazinan. Sarat Tiflu Hazinan. The male child became sad. صارت الطفلة حزينة. صارت الطفلة حزينة. The female child became sad. Dear students, in the lesson above, all the sentences have started with Sara for male or Sarat for female. And it gave the meaning of became in English. To express the meaning of became, there is another incomplete verb, Asbaha. أصبح ألف فتحة صاد سكون با فتحة حا فتحة أصبح. Both صار and أصبح are commonly used incomplete verbs to express the meaning of became in the past. Although technically the meaning of asbaha is to become in the morning, because it is derived from subh, and subh is morning, as you know. However, nowadays the word asbaha is commonly used for simply became. So you can use either sara or asbaha for the meaning became. Dear students, consider the following examples. Asbaha al-waladu muhadhaban. Asbaha al-waladu muhadhaban. The boy became polite. Asbahat al-bintu muhadhabatan. أصبحت البنت مهذبة. The girl became polite. أصبح الجو لطيفا. أصبح الجو لطيفا. The weather or atmosphere became pleasant. أصبحت الهند مشهورة. أصبحت الهند مشهورة. India became famous. أصبح الرجل غنيا. أصبح الرجل غنيا. The man became rich. أصبحت المرأة غنية. أصبحت المرأة غنية. The woman became rich. أصبح التلميذ مسرورا. أصبح التلميذ مسرورا. The male pupil or student became happy. أصبحت التلميذة مسرورة. أصبحت التلميذة مسرورة. The female pupil became happy. أصبح الطفل حزينا. أصبح الطفل حزينا. The male child became sad. أصبحت الطفلة حزينة. أصبحت الطفلة حزينة. The female child became sad. The words that have been used in this lesson and the examples given above are already familiar to you. What has been done here? Only it has been changed with asbaha and sara. And I hope that you have easily understood the sentences that have been formed above. Dear students, there is another commonly used incomplete verb is ظَلَّ. فَتْحَ ظُو لَمْ شَدَّ فَتْحَ ظَلَّ 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 for single male. And ظَلَّتْ ظَلَّتْ for single female. ظَلَّ and ظَلَّتْ, male and female, single, singular, give the meaning of went on, continued to, remained. Please consider the following examples. ظَلَّ الْوَلَدُ قَائِمًا. ظَلَّ الْوَلَدُ قَائِمًا. The boy remained standing. ظلت البنت قائمة. ظلت البنت قائمة. The girl remained standing. ظل الجو لطيفا. ظل الجو لطيفا. The weather or atmosphere remained pleasant. The word al-jawwu in Arabic conveys the meaning of atmosphere, but is also used for weather. In Arabic, for weather we use at-taqs, at-taqs, weather. For climate we use al-munakh. And for atmosphere, we use al-jaw. But generally, al-jaw is also used for atmosphere. Zallatil Hindu mashhuratan. Zallatil Hindu mashhuratan. India remained famous. Zalla ar-rajulu muntaziran. ظل الرجل منتظرا. The man remained waiting. ظلت المرأة منتظرة. ظلت المرأة منتظرة. The woman remained waiting. ظَلَّ الْبَاصُ وَاقِفًا ظَلَّ الْبَاصُ وَاقِفًا The bus remained standing. ظلت الحافلة واقفة. ظلت الحافلة واقفة. The bus remained standing. ظل الطفل حزينا. ظل الطفل حزينا. The male child remained sad. The male child remained sad. ظلت الطفلة حزينة. The female child remained sad. Dear students, now we are going to use some other incomplete verbs which are very frequently used. One such incomplete verb is ma zala. Ma zala. Ma zala. To express the meaning of still in English, the incomplete verb ma zala for single male and ma zalat for single female is used in Arabic language. Look at the following examples. ما زال الولد نائما. ما زال الولد نائما. The boy is still sleeping. The boy is still sleeping. ما زالت البنت نائمة. ما زالت البنت نائمة. The girl is still sleeping. ما زال الطقس باردا. ما زال الطقس باردا. The weather is still cold. I am sure you must be knowing the Arabic word for cold is barid and for hot is har. If you have to say the weather is hot, at-taqsu harrun. And if we have to say the weather is cold, we say at-taqsu baridun. So these two words must be familiar with you. Ma zalat al-bi'atu mumtazatan. Ma zalat al-bi'atu mumtazatan. Al-bi'a, the environment. Mumtaz, excellent. Ma zalat al-bi'atu mumtazatan. The environment is still excellent. Ma zalat tilmidhu maridan. Ma zalat tilmidhu maridan. Marid. Marid. Mariz is in the meaning of mariz. Mariz is patient, sick. Male, the male pupil is still sick. Ma zalat at-tilmizatu maridatan. Ma zalat at-tilmizatu maridatan. The female pupil is still sick. Now we are going to use another incomplete verb which is very commonly used. And that is laysa. Laysa. Laysa for male, singular male, and laysat for singular female. And this is a very commonly used incomplete verb. See the following examples. Laysal waladu na'iman. Not much has been changed in terms of vocabulary. As you can see, the same words have been used, only the incomplete verb has been changed. Laysa al-waladu na'iman. The boy is not sleeping. Laysatil bintu na'imatan. Laysatil bintu Naimatan. The girl is not sleeping. The girl is not sleeping. Laysa at'amu jahizan. Laysa at'amu jahizan. The food is not ready. I am sure you must be knowing the meaning of at'am. At'am is food. Jahiz is ready. Laysa at'amu jahizan. The food is not ready. Laysatil madrasatu kabiratan. Laysatil madrasatu kabiratan. The school is not big. Laysal ustadu mawjudan. Laysal ustadu mawjudan. The male teacher is not present, is not available. You should be knowing that for teacher, there are common words in Arabic. One is al-muallimu, al-mudarrisu, al-ustazu. Laysat at-tilmidatu ghaibatan. Laysat at-tilmidatu ghaibatan. The female pupil is not absent. Dear students, you must have noticed one regular pattern in all the sentences that have been used here, beginning with an incomplete verb. The incomplete verb, for example, kana, sara, zalla, asbaha, laysa, and others have been followed by a noun in the state of dhamma and followed by another noun with fatha and tanween. For example, laysatit tilmidatu ghaibatan. So the first noun is at-tilmidatu and the second noun is ghaibatan. So the first noun at-tilmidatu, you can notice that it has dhamma, and the second noun ghaibatan, it has fatha and tanween. You have to note that all incomplete verbs must be used in this fashion. Just for your information, there are other incomplete verbs used in Arabic language, but they are not very frequently used. For example, kana, kanat. For was. Sara, sarat. These we have already used, but I am just giving a revision. Sara, sarat, became. Zalla, zallat, continued, kept on, remained. Bata, batat. This is a new word. This is again in the meaning of became or to become. And the actual meaning is to spend the night. But it is also commonly used for to become. Another word which gives the meaning of to become is adha, adhat. Amsa, amsat. This is also to become, to become in the evening. Mazala, mazalat. To keep on, not to cease, to be, to do, is still. We have already seen the examples with mazala. Ma bariha, ma barihat. To continue, to be, to do, is still. Manfakka, manfakkat. That is, keep doing. Madama, madamat. As long as, to continue. Ma fateha, ma fateat, to continue to do. Laysa, laysat, is not. Some of the words, incomplete verbs, which we have practiced here are commonly used. Do not bother too much. अब बहुत ज़्यादा परेशान ना हो कि इतने सारे अफ़ाल को कैसे इस्तेमाल करें, अफ़ाल नाक़िसा, लेकिन इनका इस्तेमाल बहुत कम होता है. जिनके मिसालें हमने दी हैं, जिनको हमने लेसन में इस्तेमाल किया है, उनका इस्तेमाल ज़्यादा होता है, इसलिए आप बहुत ज़्यादा फिक्र ना हो. नाउ लेट अस टॉक अबाउट अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ ग्रामर. ग्रामर नोट. काना, कानत एंड इट्स सिस्टर्स आर कॉल्ड इनकम्प्लीट वर्ब्स. In Arabic, they are called afaal naqisa. Naqis ka matlab hota hai incomplete, jo mukammal nahi hai. Why they are called incomplete verbs? Because they always need a khabar, a predicate to complete the meaning. They are a group of 13 incomplete verbs that come with the nominative sentence. The mubtada in the nominative sentence becomes the noun, ism of kana and its sisters. And the khabar in the nominative sentence becomes the khabar of kana and its sisters. Kana and its sisters, kana wa akhawatuha, change the khabar's case from nominative halatul raf'i to accusative halatul nasbi. And we have already discussed kana and his sisters. They are known by different names. One name is kana and his sisters, and they are also called af'al naqisa, incomplete verbs. Just a quick recap of these incomplete verbs. Kana for male, kanat for female, Sara for male, Sarat for female, singular. Zalla for male, Zallat for female, Bata for male, Batat for female, Asbaha for male, Asbahat for female, Adha for male, Adhat for female, Amsa for male, Amsat for female, Mazala for male, Mazalat for female, Ma Bariha for male, Ma Barihat for female, Madama for male, Madamat for female, Manfakka for male, Manfakkat for female, Laysa for male, Laysat for female, Ma Fatiha for male, Ma fatiat for female. However, as I have already said, not all of these are frequently used. The more commonly used ones are kana, sara, asbaha, zalla, mazala, laysa, and madama. If you are focusing on these, if you learn these incomplete verbs, I hope that you will be able to make different sentences which we are using in our daily lives. So, dear students, hope you have understood the use of incomplete verbs, and thank you very much, and I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you very much.